Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Let's get on to PIB dated 4th of December 2019. The first press release was about launch of Bharat Bond Exchange Traded Fund. So ETF becomes important. Exchange Traded Fund is basically a fund of equities, means shares, stocks or bonds or commodities or an intermix of everything. So this is the fund, and that too is traded, that is bought and sold. Where? In the exchange market, in the over the exchange rate. So this intermix of stocks, securities, commodities and bonds, they are bought and sold over the exchange market. So they are listed onto the exchange rate, and this is what it is. So Bharat Bond ETF would be the first corporate bond ETF in the country. This much is enough. We really don't need to do any sort of PhD over what exactly are these. I mean, lot of details are also there, but this is enough, or you can do further research on your own. All right, the second press release was about the human space mission Gaganyaan. I am sure we know what this is. Gaganyaan is what? It's the first human space mission carried out by India, and GSLV MK3 launcher will be used by ISRO for the heavy lifting for the launch of this very first human space mission. That's it. Third was about this thing, that there is no need for any sort of license in order to export the herbal products. So I really didn't know this thing, but then this is the case. As per the export policy of 2018, herbal medicines export is free and does not require any license from Directorate General of Foreign Trade, and this is it. I mean, definitely certain details are there, that for certain notified commodities there is a prohibition and restrictions, but largely, broadly, basically there is no need for a license per se. All right, next was about the Northeast Rural Livelihood Project. So Northeast word is there, so ministry is either way obvious, that is M donor, Ministry for the Development of Northeastern Region, and Rural Livelihood Project, so purpose also becomes obvious, that is to uplift the livelihood of the rural people, and this is it. Also, this is World Bank aided project and launched in the year 2012. Right now it's running in the four states, that is Mizoram, Nagaland, Sikkim and Tripura, and this is it. Either way, this is not very important. Maybe somewhere down the line, if we are talking about Northeastern region, we can quote this project, but again, nothing very, very important for our prelims exam. Just keep this thing in mind, that this is a World Bank aided, and that too was launched in the year 2012. That's it. Now this is important, and this is with regard to what? Three schemes basically. So in the year 2008, Unorganized Workers Social Security Act was passed by the parliament, but in the 2017, Government of India came up with three schemes: Aam Aadmi Bima Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana, and Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana. And I'm sure we read about these schemes extensively, but unfortunately no question was asked. But right now it has resurfaced, so let's just go through it quickly once again. So what PIB is stating, that in the 2017, government has converged all these things, but what important is of course the provisions of these very schemes. So basically this is about providing insurance cover to unorganized sector. This is important. This is not for the organized sector workers. Either way, for organized people, lot many schemes are already running. So this is basically for unorganized workers. First is Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana. Jeevan means life, so it becomes obvious that this is basically to provide life insurance cover to the tune of rupees 2 lakh on the payment of premium of rupees 330 per annum. So annually one has to pay rupees 330 only in order to avail 2 lakh of insurance cover after one dies. So of course family is gonna be getting this cover. Age group is 18 to 50 years. So 18 is the minimum age and 50 is the when entry will be over. So this too is important. Please memorize this thing. Next is Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana. Here again, insurance cover would be to the tune of rupees 2 lakh on accidental death or full disability. But if there is only partial disability, then the insurance cover would be only 1 lakh. This too is important. And further, premium is rupees 12 per annum. So like Mrunal sir, I'm sure I can recall Mrunal sir explained it like this, because in Suraksha we have R and R is like 12, one straight line, and then we have a curved line, so that is how we write R. R is just like 12, so that make us say that in Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, 12 rupees would be our premium, that too per annum, and this is it. Further, age group is definitely from 18 to 70 years. This too we have to memorize. Further, total 342 rupees it has become. 330 for this very scheme, that is Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana, and 12 for Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana. This is how we get 342, and this shall be shared equally between state government and the central government. And the last point is important, this scheme would be managed through or implemented through Life Insurance Corporation of India. Alright, further PIB also talked about this third scheme, and that is Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana, that was launched in the year February 2019. So this is very very important, so I will be covering this in a separate video, because I feel this is important and the information given in PIB was not really sufficient. Alright, so we're done with this one also. Now moving on to the last one, and that too is important. This is about Senior Citizen Welfare Fund. So basically in the year 2015, through Finance Act, Government of India incorporated this thing, that is Senior Citizens Welfare Fund, and definitely for the welfare of senior citizens. But what is the point of importance is this: any unclaimed money lying under small saving schemes, employees provident fund, public provident fund schemes, life and non-life insurance schemes or policies maintained by insurance companies, and accounts of coal mines provident fund is transferred into what? It is transferred into Senior Citizens Welfare Fund. That this is it, because otherwise it's not something that we can really think of intuitively, but then this is how it is. Any unclaimed money lying under all these things would be automatically transferred into Senior Citizens Welfare Fund. So we are done with the 4th of December 2019 dated PIB as well. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.